Hello everyone and welcome back to Dynamix Academy. The topic of this video is Microsoft Dynamics 365 April 2019 release notes. We'll take a first look at Microsoft Dynamics 365 April 2019 release. Microsoft Dynamics 365 April 2019 update. Do you know that April 2019 update release, Microsoft has added 350 plus new capabilities and brand new 6 applications into its Microsoft Business application portfolio? Before looking to those new capabilities and new applications, let us now see what is the new Microsoft Dynamics 365 unified interface. That will be the most immediate thing that you will notice after April 2019 update has been applied to your Dynamics 365 instance. What are the plus points or what are the new features or what are the things that you will notice with new unified interface? With unified interface, users can now navigate with an updated sitemap. You can leverage the enhanced filtering on grids. You can save the filters to existing or new personal views. You can expand the subgrids to full view. You can quickly find records across the searchable columns in the grids. You can create personal charts. You can reset the default dashboard. You can see appointment conflicts, customize their timelines, receive improved form notifications, and many more features has been added as part of unified interface. So you can see that this is the homepage of my trial instance, which has been applied with April 2019 update. You can immediately notice that the UI has been drastically changed. You can see a very useful sitemap area on your left hand side. You can collapse as well as expand it. Earlier all your navigation used to happen from the top app navigation bar, but now that has been changed with unified interface towards the left hand side. Somehow I feel that the left hand navigation pane that used to exist in CRM 2011 is somehow restored back with a new look and feel and new functionalities as well. But still, this is the updated user navigation. All your navigation will happen from this left hand side sitemap area. In that, first of all, you will find a home page. Right now I am logged into sales module or sales app of Dynamics 365. That's why the home page is configured as sales activity social dashboard. If you change the module, then the home page for that module will be reflected here. Below the home page, you will find a recent items area where it will list out all the recently visited places in your Dynamics 365, and below that you will find a pinned item tab where it will list out all the items that you might have pinned for the most frequently visited places or area in your Dynamics 365. Right now I do not have any pinned items, so that's why it is not showing up here. Below that you will find my work area, which will contain dashboards and activities. Dashboards will list out all the dashboards pertaining to the area or the app that you have logged in. Below my work area, you will find a customer section, which will list out the accounts and contacts, which are the type of customers that you will be recording in Dynamics 365. Below that, you will be able to find the most common entities to the module or the area that you have logged in. Right now, I am to the sales module. So the commonly utilized entities in sales modules are leads, opportunities, and competitors. If you change this module, then again, it will reflect the commonly utilized entities for that particular module. Below the sales area, we'll find collateral area, which will contain mostly utilized collateral entities like quotes, orders, invoices, products, sales literature. Below that, you will find most commonly utilized marketing entities like marketing list, quick campaigns. Below that, you will find entities related to your goals management. And below that, you will find the tools, which will contain reports, as well as very commonly utilized business processes for this particular module that I have logged into. So if you want to switch from sales module to service module, then you can utilize this change area section in your sitemap. You can see a tick mark. If you want to change it to service module, you can click that and you can see your sitemap will be updated and your screen, homepage screen, will be also be refreshed to reflect the area or the module that you have selected. Right now you will be able to see the most commonly utilized entities in the service area, like cases, queues. In the collateral section, goals, tools, and you can see that earlier there were only two business processes for sales module, but now for service module I have four processes. So this is how sitemap will be keep on updating depending on the selection of the area. At the same time, I would like to show you some more cool features. Like, let us say if I want to open the accounts in my Dynamix 365 instance, you can also expand and collapse this sitemap. Let us say I want to collapse it, and you can now see the UI has been adjusted, and this is the regular homepage grid for the accounts. If you open one of the record, let us say if you open the first record, so you will be can quickly able to get the insights of that particular record from the screen itself. Let me now share you one of the interesting blog post from Jim Townsend, where he has listed out five best things about the unified interface for Dynamix 365, where he has mentioned rich user experience with new unified interface by taking the screenshot of the same record in unified interface and that of classic interface. The first screenshot or the first image you are able to see is of the new unified interface, and the same record is shown in previous interface, which is also called as classic interface. So you will be easily able to make out the differences between how Microsoft has very well managed the white spaces from its previous classic interface to that of in the new unified interface, as well as you will be able to see some of the text are bold, which are important, and the person who is logged in should be able to easily recognize, while in previous case all the text, whether be it important or not, all were within the same font as well as layout. At the same time, he goes on to say what are the top five features that he liked about the new unified interface. So you can go through this entire blog post. I'll post the link of this article in the description as well. As well as not only that, let us say if you want to switch from one record to another record, then you can use this open record set bar. You here it will show you the My Active view and simply navigate between the different records without switching back to your original view. You do not have to refresh your screen. You can simply go up and down, or you can simply switch between the records. At the same time, let me now show you. So I have switched from service to sales area back, and if you open an opportunity record, then you can see the changes in the business process area as well. You can see the how effectively the space or white space has been reduced without affecting the overall functionality, and look and feel has been drastically improved. You can see the details of that particular stage by clicking the round circle here. You can see what are the fields that has been added to that particular stage. You can also pin this flyout. If you pin this flyout, then you can see the entire details of that particular stage on your right hand side. If you change to next stage, you will be able to see the changes on your flyout as well. So this is one of the cool thing that Microsoft has adopted for new user interface, and not only for sales area. Let's say right now you have applied or you have subscribed for sales application, tomorrow you want to subscribe for finance and operations, then also the user navigation as well as the user interface will be the same, exact same. You do not feel that you have opened another entire new application. They have tried to achieve the unification amongst all the applications as part of Dynamix 365 platform, and at the same time Microsoft has also given you an option to revert back to the previous user interface or the classic user interface. How you can do that? You have to click on this settings or gear icon on the top. It will open a dialog box. Inside that you need to click advanced settings. It will open settings only page in a new tab. By default, it will take you to the business management settings area. You need to click on the arrow icon and you need to click on the administration settings under system group of settings. And if you open the administration settings, you will find an option called system settings. Click on that. Under system settings and under the general tab, which is the first tab, if you scroll down, you will see an option called use the new unified interface only, which is recommended. Right now it is set to yes. That is why it is or by default taking you to the new unified interface. If you set it to no and click OK. And after that, if you simply refresh your screen, then you will be able to revert back to your classic user interface. Now you can see that old familiar user interface has been reverted back. So this is how you will be able to achieve or revert back to the old or classic Dynamix 365 user interface. But I will strongly suggest to start utilizing the new unified interface, because that is the way forward and you need to start getting familiar with the new unified interface. So I will revert back the new unified user interface only. And at the same time, you can also see what are the 6 brand new applications that has been added Microsoft Business Application Platform, that are Dynamics 365 Customer Insights, Dynamics 365 Virtual Agent for Customer Service, Dynamics 365 Fraud Protection, Microsoft Forms Pro, Microsoft Dynamics 365 Guides, lastly Microsoft Dynamics 365 Product Visualize. So these are the 6 brand new applications that has been added to Microsoft Dynamics 365 and Power Platform. If you want to see what are the new capabilities or the new functionalities that has been added to Dynamics 365 and Power Platform, I will post the downloadable link of this official Dynamics 365 and Power Platform April 2019 release notes. On that note, I wind up this lecture. I thank you for watching this video till the end. So if you have learned something new out of this video, then please like, share and subscribe to Dynamics Academy. And also do not forget to press the bell icon so that you will never miss any update whenever we release a new video into our Dynamics Academy YouTube channel. So on that note, I take your leave and hope to see you all in the next video. Till then, bye-bye and take care.